大家好, I'm Nathan Rich, aka 火锅大王. You know, as I sift through your thousands of comments, I see patterns emerge. Hell, I can't stop seeing them sometimes. I wonder if some people realize how overtly anti-Chinese they are. Well, no need to wait around for them to realize it, because I'm going to show you one of the most revealing comments I get. Let's expose some baddies. You know, ever since I started occasionally exposing anti-Chinese leeches on the internet, their robotic racist followers have come to my channel to insult Chinese people or China itself. I delete almost every comment that calls China garbage or Chinese people various names. It's really disgusting. And then, as if I'm living in a comedy film, the other comments from their followers all deny that those channels promote racism. But the most sickening thing from my point of view isn't obvious at first. Track with me here. While I delete the directly racist comments and most of the ones with name-calling or threats in them, I tend to leave the hundreds of versions of this comment up. Here's one of the other channel's fans. His name is Panzerfaust. You know, like the weapon Germans used in World War II? He says I'm helped by the CCP. Or this person, blah, 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 something. They say, long story short, that when I post a video, a bunch of fake people, all paid by the Chinese government, come and make fake comments, and that all my comments are positive or something. And then he says, if you have any critique on my videos, someone will immediately reply to argue with you. And then he implies that negative comments are all deleted. Ironically, after a week, his comment remains and no one has replied to it. So sad, these conspiracy people. When you're on this side of the content, it all becomes clear. There are people out there, a lot of people, who just always think everything is a conspiracy. Get a cat or something, people. You have way too much time on your hands. But the fact that this person is a conspiracy weirdo is not the point. What do these two comments have in common? Well, the core message that they're sending is the same. They call me a pretender. They suggest I work for some other entity than myself. They claim I have some kind of ulterior motives. But you see, the way they're doing it is actually quite anti-Chinese. Let's zoom out for a minute. Let's discuss my home country, America. I love America. Now, does anyone have a problem with that? Does anyone think that the American government paid me to say that? No. All right. I love Thailand. Other than the insane heat that makes me a puddle of embarrassing sweat, the experience of Thailand is great. And what's more, there are always Chinese people around to hang out with. Now I ask you again, do you think the Thai government paid me to say that? If someone comments that they love Thailand, are they fake? Take a look at this video. I just searched for America's Great. Is Ellen DeGeneres a shill for the American government? How about this one? This guy loves Germany. Is he working for the government? No? Why not? Are you starting to see the problem? All these commenters, mostly white foreigners who have never been to China, find out the channels that they were following are anti-Chinese. They get mad at me for exposing it. Then they come to attack me. But in the way that they choose to do it, they actually prove me right. Channels that pretend to show China in a neutral way but slip in racist undertones create racism. They create an elusive bias in people. They create this anti-Chinese sentiment that wasn't there before. They are proving this to you time and time again when they come to my channel and post. You see, if you think carefully about what they're saying, it all comes out. If someone likes Germany, or America, or anywhere else, no problem. But if someone likes China, then there's no possible way that it's true. It must be a lie. It has to be fake. There's no way anyone could actually love China because in their minds, China is that bad. They are so anti-Chinese that they literally cannot believe that somebody could love it. Do you see it now? What a strange way to try to prove their point. They're just exposing the real truth again and again. They wouldn't be so hateful towards a place they've never even been to if they stopped watching covert hate channels. So stop supporting those channels. Don't send me links to them. I won't watch the videos. Don't watch them. Don't click them. Don't share them. And don't talk about them. Let them fade from existence. They just breed hate. I mean, I have the China flag tattooed on my hand, for crying out loud. Do these racists think the government likes hand tattoos of Chinese flags? You're kind of not supposed to get tattoos of the flag, and Chinese society looks down on tattoos. I did it because I'm me and I'm real. And yes, sometimes I'm a little offensive looking. Sorry. The next time you see someone so positive that there's just no way I can mean what I say, ask yourself this. Why do they think it's impossible to love China? What is it about China specifically that they hate so much? Do they even know? I'll never apologize for my message. It's okay to love China. Thanks, everybody. 谢谢.